He doesn't look well, whoever he is.
I don't think it is a person. I think it's a doll.
What? But the magician and Auntie Flo haven't got any dolls.
Well, it looks like a doll.
Yes, I suppose it does. But if it is a doll, it's the biggest one I've ever seen. Come on, let's take a closer look.
See? I told you it was a doll.
Oh, hello, you three.
Hello, Auntie Flo. We've come to get a closer look at your doll.
Doll? What doll? Oh, you mean this. This isn't a doll. It's a scarecrow.
Oh! What's a scarecrow?
Well, can't you guess? Think of the name. Scarecrow.
Scarecrow. Scarecrow? Oh, of course! You use it to scare crows!
Well, that's right. But actually, you use it to frighten all sorts of birds, not just crows.
Mm. But why should you want to scare them? I like birds.
Well, so do I, Maple. But you know, they can be a bit of a nuisance in the garden, eating the seeds before they grow into plants.
Yes, and they eat fruit as well. Auntie Flo's got lots of raspberries and strawberries in her back garden, and the birds have been eating them before she can pick them.
Oh, that is a nuisance, isn't it?
Yes, it is. So I want to do something about it. But I don't want to hurt them, so I thought I'd scare them away with my scarecrow.
Oh, I see. Well, what do you do? Throw the scarecrow at them?
Oh, no. No, I'll just put him in my back garden. And that should be enough to scare the birds away.
And then there'll be plenty of strawberries and raspberries and things for all of us.
He doesn't seem a very scary sort of scarecrow. Yeah. He's got a friendly face. What's it made of?
Well, it's a turnip, you see. We've cut out some eyes and a mouth and given him a carrot nose. Good, isn't he?
Yes, but I don't think he'll scare many birds.
Why not?
Because he looks too kind. I don't think he's scary at all. And he can't move, can he?
Well, no, of course not.
Well, then, listen, Mr. Scarecrow. Music.
Scare the crows, how will you manage to scare the crows? Standing there all day long, can't even whistle or sing a song. Can't jump up or wave your arms about. Can't say boo or scare us with a shout. Ha! Can't do a thing, so goodness knows how he will manage to scare the crows. Ha!
Very good, Toby. But you know, he doesn't have to jump about and shout to frighten the birds.
How does he do it then?
Well, just by standing in the garden. You see, the birds will think he's a person, and because they don't like coming near people if they can help it, well, they'll just fly away.
Yes. And when we get some clothes on him, the wind will flap them around a bit, and that will make it look as though he's moving.
What sort of clothes does a scarecrow wear?
Oh, any sort, just so long as nobody wants them anymore. I mean, it'd be silly to put new clothes on a scarecrow.
Oh, I know where there are some old clothes. Shall I go and fetch them?
Well, yes, please.
All right, I won't be long.
You know, I think our scarecrow needs a name, don't you?
Good idea. What should we call him?
I know. I thought of a marvellous name for him.
What?
Mr. Scarecrow.
Yes, but, well, don't you think it's a bit ordinary? Oh, come on, let's think of a nice special name for him.
All right. Norman.
Huh? Why Norman?
Because Norman rhymes with strawman. Norman Strawman.
Norman Strawman.
Oh, yes. Very good, Snodgrass. Well, I'm pleased to meet you, Norman Strawman.
Here we are. Some clothes for the scarecrow.
You mean Norman Strawman? Mm. We've decided to give him a name, you see. He's called Norman Strawman now.
Norman Strawman? Oh, right, hang on. I'll start again. Here we are, some clothes for Norman Strawman.
Oh, lovely. Let's see what you've got.
I never wear that jacket now. You see, it's too small, so I thought Norman could have it, if it fits him.
Well, I don't think it will, Toby. Oh. Of course it won't. Oh. It's much too small.
Well, never mind. Here's something else that will fit in. There we go.
Oh, thank
and
you.
And it'll flap around in the breeze, too.
Splendid.
Hey.
Look.
Hey, that's mine.
Oh, come on, magician, it's all torn, look.
Well, it may be, but I don't care. I like this robe, and I'm not putting it on any scarecrow. No, if we want some clothes for him, I'll make some with a spell.
Oh, all right, then. Let's go over to Barrel and see what she can do for us.
Right. Morning, Barrel.
Hello, everybody. What can I do for you today?
Well, we want to dress our scarecrow, so we need some clothes, and we thought we'd like to make some with a spell.
I see. Well, if we're going to make clothes, we need something beginning with ka. I haven't had a cup of coffee for ages.
Oh, that begins with ka, doesn't it? Very well. Here you are. A cup of coffee.
Thank you. Now we need a colour beginning with S for scarecrow.
S for scarecrow.
That's hard, isn't it?
I know. Look. My scarlet scarf.
Scarlet.
Scarlet. Oh, it's a red colour.
That's right, Snodgrass. There.
Now it's the magic tune, isn't it? Can I remind the magician of that?
Who said I needed reminding? It goes, pom, pom. It goes, oh, very well, remind me then.
Pom, 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 pom.
That's right. Thank you, Maple. All together now. Pom, 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 pom. Now the magic clap. And finally, the magic rhyme. Puddle muddle, muddle puddle, Norman Strawman standing there. Muddle puddle, puddle muddle, he shall have some clothes to wear.
Look, he's dressed in clothes, all right, magician. He's got your robe and hat on.
Oh, well, I suppose he might as well wear them then. Actually, they rather suit him, don't you think?
Yes, but he still doesn't look scary.
Well, I think he does.
I don't, and I don't think the birds will be too worried by him. Perhaps you should use something else to scare them away, Auntie Flo. Why don't you ask the Gruffle to stand in your garden?
Oh, yes. He's really scary.
Oh, yes. Do you remember the time he went down Puddle Lane and frightened everybody?
I do. What happened?
Oh, why don't we go over to the bird bath and find out?
Oh, yeah.
Well, you can if you like. I've got other things to do.
I think he's sulking because we don't think his scarecrow scary.
I heard that, Snodgrass, and I'm not sulking. You'll see how scary Norman will be when you come back from the bird bath.
What do you mean? Are you going to do something to Norman Strawman to make him more frightening?
You'll see.
Ooh, you're up to something, magician. Well, no doubt we'll find out what it is later. Well, come on, let's go over to the bird bath and find out what the Gruffle got up to in Puddle Lane. Come on. Right.
Now, Maple, you were wondering what happened when the Gruffle went down Puddle Lane,
Yes, I must say I'm glad I wasn't there. I know I'm quite brave, but I think I'd have been a bit scared.
Yes, but the Gruffle would have been more scared of you. He's frightened of mice, isn't he?
He is, yes.
And there was a mouse waiting for him in Puddle Lane, as you will see.
Right.
The Gruffle was a gruff and grumpy monster. His grandfather was a dragon, and he didn't like people. He liked to be left alone. Early one morning, the Gruffle went out of the magician's garden and down Puddle Lane. Old Mr. Go-to-Bed, who lived in the first house, had just made himself a cup of tea. But the milk was sour, so old Mr. Go-to-Bed opened his window and tossed the tea out into the lane. Swoosh! It landed on the Gruffle's head. The Gruffle roared with rage. Smoke and flame shot out of his mouth. Oh! Cried Mr. Go-to-Bed, looking out of the window. Oh, I must be having a nightmare. He ran back to bed and pulled up the bedclothes. The Gruffle went on down the lane, feeling crosser than ever. At that moment, Mr. Puffle opened his window to water his flowers. The Gruffle saw him and roared with rage. Mr. Puffle was so startled that he dropped his watering can. It fell with a crash on the Gruffle's head. The Gruffle roared again in fury. Mr. Puffle slammed the window shut and covered his eyes. Oh, there's no such creature, he said. I must be imagining it. And when he looked out between his fingers, the lane was empty. But the Gruffle was still there. He was almost invisible. Only his ears were showing, and he was peering through Mrs. Pitter-Patter's front window, watching her drink a cup of tea. The Gruffle didn't like the look of Mrs. Pitter-Patter. He gave a sudden roar, and the whole of him came into view. Mrs. Pitter-Patter looked up. She saw a great red monster looking in at the window. She dropped her cup and fainted. At that moment, the Gruffle heard a little squeak behind him. He turned and saw Chestnut Mouse sitting in Puddle Lane. He gave one last frightened roar and vanished. Chestnut Mouse climbed up the wall and looked in at Mrs. Pitter-Patter's window. He ran in. The Gruffle's always afraid of mice, he said to himself, as he helped himself to Mrs. Pitter-Patter's breakfast. I'm so glad that I'm a mouse, not a Gruffle.
Quite right, too. I'd rather be a mouse than a Gruffle any day. But was Mrs. Pitter-Patter all right?
Oh, yes. She just had a bit of a fright, that's all.
Yes, but the Gruffle had an even bigger fright when he saw Chestnut Mouse.
Yes. Well, shall we go and see if the magician's done anything to make the scarecrow more scary?
Oh, yes. It did seem as if he was going to do something, didn't it? Come on, let's go and see.
Right. Well, he doesn't seem to have done anything at all. Norman seems just the same to me.
Ah, but we can't see his face. Perhaps the magician has given him a scarier one.
No, he hasn't.
Who said that?
I don't know.
Very strange. There seemed to be anyone around. Oh, perhaps it's the scarecrow.
Scarecrows can't speak, can they?
Oh, yes, they can.
I think that was the scarecrow.
No, it can't be.
It was? Huh? Look, it's moving.
Oh, magician, what a trick to play.
You gave us a fright.
Oh, sorry, but I just wanted to show you how scary our scarecrow could be. After all, you did tease Norman.
Oh, yes, well, you certainly frightened us, didn't he?
Yes, well, see if you can get this broomstick out of my sleeves, please, Auntie Flo. It's a little bit uncomfortable.
Right.
Oh, God, yes.
I'm afraid I can't. Seems to be stuck.
Stuck? But I can't walk around like this all day.
You don't have to walk about, magician.
What do you mean?
Just go and stand quietly in Auntie Flo's back garden. She could do with a good scarecrow like you.
Oh, honestly.